I don't know whether you watched the debate, but I want to get a sense from you for us in our region. If there's another 4 years of Mr. Trump in the White House, do we have a safer region because of the alliances that he has struck, or do we have a risk of greater tension? Good morning.
Good morning. Well, I was watching part of the debate, and it is entertaining, but entertaining in a way, disappointing, unfortunately, with the, you know, President of the United States and candidate Vice President Biden. I mean, it wasn't expected that attack to each other in very bad way. But unfortunately, I mean, sometimes democracy allowing you to do that, unfortunately. As far as, you know, I mean, definitely, I mean, we have, and I'm talking my personal capacity, I mean, we have seen what the damages came during President Obama and Vice President Biden to the countries like Iraq, like Libya, like a lot of countries, and supporting and appointing, I can say, Iran to be the governor of the area, which is unacceptable to us. Well, I'm not against Democrats at all, but, you know, sometimes you can see something which doesn't let you comfortable or relax. President Trump made a portable footpath for us. I mean, at least he created something called business peace. I don't want to call it the peace because we don't have border, we don't have war. It is the economical arrangement between us and Israel. That is really an achievement with Donald Trump did, and with the achievement with our leaders and the Israeli leader. I mean, that's something to give us the comfort.
Okay, but let's just talk a little bit about that, Khalaf. Let's just talk a little bit about that, because I do want to understand from you the Abraham Accord. Do you think it bolsters the position against Iran? Was that the primary driver? You speak to many people. Was that the real driver? It was a hedge against Biden getting back in, reasserting the 2015 deal. Is that what you see as being the driver of this deal?
I think, you know, our relation with the American is very strong relationship. And we have, you know, friendly and military and et cetera. I think we are not expecting Israeli military relationship a lot. While, you know, we have in United Arab Emirates and GCC, Saudi Arabia, I think we have the power to defend our country and with the also cooperation of United States of America. Our aim is to do business with the Israelis, to do business, because we are in the same caliber of mentality of businessmen, which is really, that is very much bring us all together and will be great achievement. This is warming up now. It is warming up between us. Yes, sir.
Okay, and part of that is the Mobileye partnership that I know that you've done. So that's about driverless cars. I fear for Sheikh Zayed Road. I'm bad on it in a car myself, so driverless, let's see how it goes. Are you prepared to put physical dollars onshore into Israel? And if so, what kind of businesses would you like to invest into Israel?
Well, first of all, this is a great achievement to sign with the Mobileye, this agreement and other agreement as well. And this is, I call it a warm-up. And this warm-up will let us, you know, expand in Israel and the Israeli to invest in my country. Okay. This is really with our door and their doors open. And we have a plan to do that soon. As soon as, you know, the lockdown is finished in Israel, and I'm planning to visit as well.
Okay, let's talk about the business here, Khalaf. I know that it's a challenge. I've been to a couple of pool days. I haven't tried the Habtoor yet, but you've got 7 properties here. What is the occupancy looking like for the winter season? Are you going to have to close any of these hotels, is the bottom line? Are you going to have to shave back on any of the occupancy capacity?
No, we didn't really close, you know. We are, for example, Habtoor City, the palace was open all the time. And the Polo was open, and we are doing, I mean, better than the years before in the Polo. But the other hotel we open now, there is improvement. We can see a visitor, local visitors, we mean resident and local. Plus, we have people from Russia, former Soviet Union countries coming, you know, we hope the lockdown in Europe, like Britain, to open and to allow the people, then we will see huge business improvement. I can tell you within 2-3 months will be improved, you know, provided we, you know,
Is that critical, Khalif? Is that the critical point? You need an air bridge between us and the UK. Is that a lifeline to business of Dubai for you and the other people running these businesses here?
That's true. You know, we have great relationship with the British, and we want them to ease things, to allow the people without quarantine. Of course, we accept and we have to respect the rule and regulation of the medical advisors, and we can do that. In Dubai, we do, United Arab Emirates, we are respecting every instruction from our health ministry and department, and that will be implemented to everybody. There is no exception. But, you know, quarantine, we are not doing quarantine to anybody. Let them free in their houses, they quarantine themselves, and they respect that, yes.
Khalif, you make your money on doing deals. Are there any big opportunities out there in health, education, or hotels? Do you take advantage of what is a great crisis for all of us? And if so, where?
The problem is, I mean, the damage is in the tourism area, like hotels, airline, etc., which we are suffering not only in Dubai, also elsewhere. We have 7 hotels overseas, and we are suffering from that, you know, a lot.
But are you ready to buy any more if there's value out there? Briefly, in 30 seconds, Khalif, are you ready to pounce if there's a deal on the table for you?
If there is opportunity and you have, you will be paid as a broker, brokerage fees. You will be paid as a brokerage fees, yes.
Sir,